That was possibly one of my most surreal moments because I was in the middle of watching a movie at a movie theater on a Sunday afternoon when I got an email from Ben Rhodes, our deputy national security advisor, and said, can you come to the office for a meeting at 6:30? And my first thought was, this isn't good. Because, you know, that's not an email you normally get. Normally, it would certainly would be more explicit about what the topic was. And when I asked, he made it clear he couldn't tell me over email. So I got to the office having no idea what it could be, fearing the worst, you know, something terrible happening during our campaign in Libya at the time, you know, a threat to the homeland. And then to find out a short, you know, few minutes after getting the White House that the president, that, you know, had fulfilled this promise, had done something that really helped turn the page on sort of the decade post 9/11. And then, you know, that whole experience and then leaving the White House at like 2:30 in the morning with being able to hear from my office people chanting USA on Pennsylvania Avenue was, it was one of the great front row seats to history I got to have, to be able to see not the, obviously the operation or the decision to do the operation, but, you know, that sort of that night and how it all came together, you know, with the speech and everything else. It was fascinating.
How was his mood after that? Exultant?
Yeah, exultant. I don't think it's exultant because I think it was pleased for America, relieved that the operation, I mean, this was as big a bet that a president could take, I think. You know, and he had to do it against, as some folks have said, the advice of some of his cabinet. And to have it have worked out, to have, I can only imagine what it's like for him to be sitting there to hear about the one helicopter going down, to think for a second there that he's going to have a situation like Jimmy Carter had
the thought had to pass his mind, as it did for Bob Gates.
Yes, absolutely. And to think that this could end up, you know, he placed a big bet and it looked for a second there like it would fail. To have done that, and then to have, you know, had the chance to call President Bush and President Clinton and talk to him about it. You know, I think he was, you know, relieved it had gone well. You know, I think proud that that he'd be able to accomplish something that it had taken so long, and I think happy for America because it clearly meant something pretty powerful to the American people. You could just see that in the response sort of all across the country that night.